Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Joey Roulette posted a tweet saying FCC approves transfer of swarm licenses to SpaceX as the two companies merge. NASA posted a tweet saying, launch update, NASA and SpaceX are now targeting 2:21 a.m. Eastern Time Sunday, October 31st for the Crew 3 mission to the space station. Crew 3 is scheduled to arrive at the orbiting laboratory early on the morning of Monday, November 1st. I wanted to share this tweet from Michael Sheets. It says, Morgan Stanley surveyed institutional investors and industry experts on two SpaceX versus Tesla questions. 1. Which is a more attractive investment? 2. Which has the potential to be more valuable over the long term? 63% answered SpaceX for both. Heading over to Boca Chica, here's a view of the orbital launch site. The skates for rolling the chopstick catching arms up and down the tower were installed. Yesterday, the catching arms were hooked up to the crane to be installed on Mechazilla with installation today. One of the large tanks to store methane was moved to the launch site. A cryo tank shell for the orbital tank farm was also rolled out. This tank shell was then sleeved with a GSE tank. Mary posted a tweet on Tuesday of the other large propellant tank and final cryo shell arriving at the launch site. The final tank shell was also sleeved yesterday. Here's a view of the progress on the stairs at the propellant production site. Crews have been continuing to work on the booster thrust simulator. There is a CNET article related to the FAA public hearing on SpaceX's plans for orbital Starship flights. It says dozens of people had the chance on Monday to let the US government know how they feel about SpaceX's plan to begin orbital flights of Starship from Starbase. A majority of the public comments given during an online hearing held on Zoom by the Federal Aviation Administration were in support of the development of Elon Musk's next generation space vehicle. A new Starship aft section was spotted having been sleeved recently. On Monday, the Starship 20 prototype fired up its engines for the first time and performed a Preburner test. Looking at the road and beach closures on the Cameron County website, SpaceX used the Monday closure for Starship testing. Then they also had a closure on Tuesday which was cancelled during the day. They also had another closure scheduled for today for the Starship 20 static fire, but that was cancelled. There is a new closure for tomorrow, Thursday 21st, hopefully for the static fire test. Then there's also a closure for Monday 25th and Tuesday 26th. A crane was detached on the progressing Starship 21 nose cone barrel section. Crews continue to work on Super Heavy Booster 4 as it gets ready for its own testing. As always, I have to thank both Mary, known as Boca Chica Gal, and Nick Ansuini for being out in Boca Chica all the time filming the amazing content. Also, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working hard behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.